till the midnight sun. Wheels go round and round on my mind. Restless hearts sleep alone tonight, sending all my love along the wire. They say that the road ain't no place to start a family. Right down the line, it's been you and me. Love and a music man ain't always what it's supposed to be. Oh, girl, you stand by me. I'm forever yours, faithfully.
We went to Devon and the West Country, and it was Roy who gave Nigel his first driving lessons. And Roy was always obsessed with cars, never drove very far, but he changed it every single year. Anyway, he took Nigel on his first lesson. We have it down to the seafront, and in Clacton there's a steep road that goes called Pier Avenue, and it goes down to the where the pier is, and then there's a slope down to the beach. Well, he drove Nigel down this, and he drove out onto the slope halfway down. The tide was coming in, it was lapping at the bottom of this slope. And he said to him, now reverse it back. So that's Nigel's first time. Apparently, that was what our granddad had done to Roy when he was Anyway, Nigel always loved being helpful. He just loved that. So it was his, right from a little boy, he liked to be helpful. And I can remember, Mum, it was her different way, a unique way really, sort of thinking out the box, anyway, to try and solve problems. So one time, Mum's radio had stopped working, and he said, I can do it. Anyway, he had all these contraptions, one of which was definitely a spoon, I can remember that. And he got it working, and I can remember Mum's face going, oh, thank you, Nigel. Not quite sure what to make of it. Anyway, yeah, Nigel's first job was in Harwich, and he came home one day and he made me metal shapes because he knew I liked doing patchwork. That was the sort of thing, he was always doing little things. And Roy loved music. Roy subscribed us to a music club. And so every month, they weren't the actual artists, but we'd get very, you know, they were like the takeoffs of the artists. So we were always up to date in the latest music. And that's probably where Nigel started loving his music from. It certainly wasn't me. Christmas, when we were young, was fun, because we went to Nan and Grandad's, and there was quite a few relations. And Grandad played the piano by ear, so we'd all take down. It was a real old traditional. Sort of a London time, really, because they came from London originally, you know, and so we used to sing all the old Cockney songs. Anyway, when I went to college, Mum and Nigel were very close, but whenever I came home, he made me laugh. He always said, well, I'm going out for the first evening, because I just never stopped talking when I got back, and he said, no, I'll leave you to it. Our mum was great fun, and she was just a lovely person. So when she died, Nigel and I were both devastated. And it was the next year that he emigrated to America with Sharon and Becky. So John and I and our girls, we had some lovely holidays in Florida to start when our girls were young. Nigel and Sharon, they took us all over to the Disney and all the things. And the first time, Roy came with us, so that was lovely. And when Nigel moved to Oregon, some new adventures opened up. And I've just got to say, Nigel was truly my big brother, although he was younger. He overtook me in height when I was 5. I wasn't impressed by that. I loved him to bits, and even though we were 5,000 miles apart, we spoke every week, and we were still very close. And I miss
him. Good friend, not only with myself, but also my brother Ernie. Each other for well over 30 years. He was a good guy, and there were a couple of characteristics that I always liked about Nigel. Although he had a sarcastic and antagonistic attitude sometimes, it was always in good jest, and he truly and deeply cared for anyone he did joke about. I always knew where Nigel was coming from, and he was never two-faced. He spoke his mind to his favor, and his demise sometimes. Another characteristic about Nigel that I admired was he's always cared for the underdog and always helped those in need, something that not too many people knew. He admired Sharon and his three daughters and always so proud of all of them. I did not get to see Nigel so much since he flew to Thailand for my wedding, but when he came here, we had a great time and he left an impression on all as a kind, gentle, spirited giant. Take care, my friend, and it is my belief that we will see each other again in paradise with the best of health returned. Take care, Ring. Okay. This one. This is written by Sarah, his middle daughter. On behalf of my mom and my sisters, I would like to express our sincere gratitude to everyone for your love, support, kind words and gestures over the past weeks. We are extremely grateful as it has helped carry each of us through this difficult time. Nigel, Dad, Granddad, or whatever you choose to call him, he was your father, brother, husband, friend, and granddad. Our dad was fun and amazing. He certainly was one of a kind. While growing up, he was the definition of low maintenance, which I guess was a good thing with three daughters. He always enjoyed telling people that he had three daughters and had to purchase his son, the dog. During his years of life, he was quite the traveler. He has been to Singapore, Thailand, Australia, Mexico, Canada, and all over Europe. The places he went, the people he met, and the things he did all played such an important part of his adult life. A world of adventure was at his grasp, and from what we know, he grasped it all while he could. Growing up, I admired his stories from his travels, and I believe it was from him where I developed my own love of traveling. Our dad was a lesson in loyalty, devotion, and commitment. He was generous and a great listener, always without judgment. His actions taught me that the highest form of love is consideration. He had an amazing way of making each of us girls feel like we were his favorite. Our dad was comforting presence to all of us. We loved our dad so much and will miss him dearly. I feel so treasured to have been able to share a part of his life and call him dad. All of us will miss his smile and laughter, but have all the great memories to keep in our hearts. He has left a legacy in his daughters and grandson that will continue on. The price of love is grief, and today we grieve the loss of my dad, whom I will miss dearly. Thank you. Emotionally connected to is Becky. So this is Becky's. They say there is a reason. They say time will heal. Neither time nor reason will change the way I feel. Gone are the days we used to share, but in my heart, you are always there. The gates of memories will never close. I'm so thankful for all the memories we shared together. anybody knows. Every day without you has been hard, but on this day especially, I can't help but think how much I wish you were here with me. Things I've learned from Dad. Love for music. Love for driving a car with all the windows down, playing your favorite song. Love for animals, especially dogs. How to save money. How to work hard and have good work ethics. To put others first and help those in need. To always tell the ones you love, I love you, even if they don't always say it back. To hold your head up high and stay strong through difficult times. And the importance of family, even when times are rough. I know you're watching over me, and I want you to know that I'm trying my best to live a life that would make you proud. I love you more than words can say, and I will always cherish the memories we made together with all my love, Becky.
You said it so greatly. As a father, that's all we want is for our children, you know, to work hard, to respect others, to love, to be good people. And that was so beautiful. But the first time I got to meet Sarah and her family, as I told my son when he was getting buried, I said, when you get buried, you marry the family. Family is a very much part of your life. You take the good and the bad with them. And the first time I got to meet Nigel, and I seen how he loved the dogs, loved his kids. I knew my son was going to make the right decision. As somebody that lost their parents very young, I know the pain. And I just, he was such a neat man. It was, the more alcohol we had, the harder we The tongue got a little thicker. And we had a Thanksgiving at my house. And if you've ever been to my house, it's one of those about 40 miles ago, you think you've made the wrong turn. It's farther and farther. And us Americans know the movie Deliverance. You think you should hear something playing in the distance. But as Nigel and them came up, and we just had such a great day. We had cocktails. We seen the woods that we live in. And I truly gained a whole other respect for Nigel, because he was a very intelligent man, very witty man, and very, very much a blessing to have in our lives. I miss you.
And, we know Nigel and the Palmer family for well over 25 years. We actually live across the street from each other. As we were moving into our development, we happened to see this truck come up and started disgorging furniture, kids, family, and we thought, oh, okay, this is strange. It wasn't until our kids started to play with them. You know, Sarah, Becky, Emily, that kind of got to know each other. And so we started to develop a friendship through our kids. And much like Nigel, I too got to share his son. Bailey, as far as I'm concerned, as much of my son as he was Nigel's. And Bailey and I, we have great time. Bailey would come up and see me, and just automatically piddle. And everything like that. And you know, I'd ask for permission, but can I feed Bailey occasional steak or a bratwurst or something? And Nigel took it in, you know. Nigel essentially was a very, very good friend. You know, I'll say that. He was more of a brother. You know, my brother and I, we aren't close, but I sure as heck was a lot closer with Nigel. We could go and Our favorite thing was going out to movies because we could not get the bosses to come with us. Literally speaking, there was a movie, certainly action movie, Nigel and I, we were on it. And, you know, we used to occasionally go out every Sunday night just before the start of the work day. We'd have our bosses with us and we'd go down and have a drink just to celebrate the end of the week and gear up for the following week. And over the years, you know, we watched our families grow. You know, kids growing up from college, you know, getting married, having children of their own. And, you know, over the last couple of years that, you know, Nigel and I trying to figure out what to do. I retired and I did not know what to do with my life, but there was one constant that I could be guaranteed that Nigel would go to the movies with me. And, you know, he would go willingly without any argument because it was something to do to get out of the house. I miss him, and I'm sure all of us miss him in our own way. So, Nigel, wherever you're at, you are sorely missed. And I want to thank you for being part of my life.
For a little over 20 years. I met him when I came to work at a place where he was working before. And somehow we kind of worked very well together. We started developing a friendship. We got to know each other outside of work. We were invited to his home. We invited him out to ours. And, you know, again, he was a developing friendship that was ongoing from day to day, actually till this day as far as I'm concerned. The only thing that I really want to share about Nigel is there was two things that he loved. One is he loved to go to Buffalo Wild Wings and have a Stella. And that was our regular meet. You know, in the beginning we would do that almost weekly, and then after I retired it was maybe once a month or whenever, but we always did something together. And the other thing we loved to do together that he loved more than anything else was to talk politics. We never disagreed. We always saw each other's side, sometimes on the same side or not, but again, as an open-minded person, he was a great person to help anybody, you know, just be friendly with and be open and honest. And one of the few things he did tell me in our course of time is that he always wished he became a citizen of the U.S. It was his goal. He never got there. But for Nigel, the next Stella is for us.
At Lamps, Lamps or Us. Or Lamps Plus. Looking at lamps for our new homes in Sterling Park. And of course, Sharon will know now that I walk up, I say, oh, I heard you say Sterling Park. Where are you going to be? And they look down their very precious noses at me. Like, who are you? And really, I didn't get to meet them, you know, and get friends with them for a while after that. But, but you know, we've made our peace with that. Nigel contributed so much to those times. As Troy will know, you had Thanksgiving at their house, too. And he smoked turkeys like you couldn't believe. He smoked ribs. We all loved it. His hamburgers were to die for, and you know, we really counted on him at those, a lot of those meals, to do those grilling things for us, and he loved doing it. He was proud of doing it. He wanted to make sure we did, it was right, it was good, it was cooked all the way through, etc. And the movies, the bosses, and some of us others did get to go to movies too. We even rented one of those whole rooms one time.
Yes, we did.
And to go to a movie together, about 20 of us did.
Yep.
We played cards again. You know, it can get pretty competitive. Nigel would like to win Even our newest member knew, Steve, you know that Nigel liked to win, even in these last few months. So, so many good memories. And the dogs, and of course, the family and the girls, and just being part of that neighborhood that we all love being part of, and I still get to come back to and have those wonderful memories of Nigel.
The time out of your one day off to come and be able to remember him in such special ways. We really appreciate your coming and sharing that love and hope that you will continue to stay connected with them. They need it. And I think you do too, because it's the community, the network that holds you together. And whether you believe in God or not, I can tell you my God loves every single one of you. And it's worth pulling together. It's worth being there for each other. It's worth helping each other, even when it's inconvenient. I'm grateful that I could be here today and share this with you. And the family says thank you very much, and that you can have safe travels getting home. Some of you have come very long distances.
Living in a lonely world, took a minute.